The United Student Movement is the student government of Northern Caribbean University with the duty to uphold and maintain the standards of the university by promoting the habits of using one's body and time for God. They encourage student pride in our institution and aim to bridge the gap between students and administration by advocating on our behalf. Thus, increasing unity and cooperation among the student body. Ladies and gentlemen, both here and online, welcome to day two of our presidential and vice presidential debates for the United Student Movement 2024 to 2025 regime. Yesterday, the candidates would have presented their manifestos and were given with questions from our panelists. Today, they will remind us of their plans in their manifestos and after be questioned by the student population. Before we continue, let us go into our devotion and opening prayer led by Miss Rajani Miller.
Good afternoon, everyone. Please bow your heads with me as we pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the chance we have to meet with each other, to change over, to make new beginnings. As we go into this short devotion, I ask that you'll be with us, guide us, and speak to our hearts. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Ephesians 4, verse 11 says, So Christ himself gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the pastors, and teachers to equip his people for works of service, so that the body of Christ may be built up until we all reach unity in the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the fullness of Christ. Leadership is everywhere in our world. There are good leaders and bad leaders, wise leaders and foolish ones. Some leaders impact many people, such as an entire nation, while other leaders impact fewer, such as members of the United Student Movement executive. It is important that we understand the impact that we can make in the lives of others, no matter where we are in life. As Christians, when we are put in positions of leadership, even in our class setting, we are called to care about those around us and serve them with godly leadership. Our leadership should be more than just power, influence, or individual purpose. Rather, it should show Christ's love to others, and we should be filled with his purpose and intent. Leading with purpose requires more than just our strength. It requires us to rely on God and to look to the Bible, where he has shown us examples of godly leadership. Each day, we get to choose what kind of leader, what type of person we get to be. We are equipped with the tools we need to make right choices as we develop long-term leaders through the Word of God and through the testimonies. And I would like to encourage everyone here. You may not be a USM executive member, you may not be a club executive member, but you have some influence in some parts of this world. And you get the choice, you have to make the choice. How will I use this influence that I have to work for others, either for the better or for the worst? It is up to you to decide. Let us pray. Please stand with me as we pray. Heavenly Father, sometimes we cannot make the choice on our own. We know that we should make right choices. We know that we have to influence others for good and for your name's sake. But of ourselves, we are weak, and we want to do our own thing most of the time. Now I'm asking you to come into our hearts, to fill us, and to give us the power to choose the right. Give us the power to choose your way. And as we go into this segment of the presidential debates, I ask that you will be with the candidates and be with all those who have questions. Give wisdom, guidance, clarity, and let us enjoy this session, I ask. In Jesus' name I pray, Amen.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. It gives me great privilege to welcome you again to the USM Town Hall. This is the Vice Presidential and Presidential Town Hall, where you, the students, get a chance to ask your questions based on the observations you would have been making from yesterday's debate. So the host will come and she'll give you your general instruction. But I just want to say thank you to the candidates for giving yourself to service. I just want to give, can everyone give them a round of applause? Because it takes someone of courage to come to face the students, even if they don't feel like they're ready, you know, to just come here and face you all, that is a big step. So thank you for giving them a round of applause. I want to take the time to welcome all of you, observing our USM President, Leandra Wilmot, who is in our midst, the elections policies, the Elections Planning and Overseeing Committee members who are also present here. And for those who are watching online, thank you for making it USM this year. And I hope that you all will exercise your right to vote in next week's election. So please don't kill them. Take your time, ask the necessary questions so that they can feel the need to even do better in whatever venture that they are about to take on. Leadership is hardship. And so we know that this will require a lot of effort, but leaders, thank you for taking on the mantle. So I will hand over back to our host to give you the general instruction. We will be, please ensure that your questions are brief. Summarize them as best as possible because we want to ensure that we abide by the time slot as we prepare also for the rest of the sectionals and the end of term, the end of semester examination. So please be frank. Thank you. Please be forward with your questions, and leaders, answer the questions as best as you can in as little time as possible. Have a productive afternoon, everyone.
Come on, let me hear a louder round of applause. Let me hear it. Yes, and give one to the candidates. They want it right now. Nice. Right, love that. So, welcome again to the second presidential and vice presidential debates for the United Student Movement 2024-2025 regime. Today's debate is very different from the style experience yesterday. Yesterday we had the panelists here, but today guess who will be asking the questions? The students will be asking the questions. So the candidates, you will be given a minute to give a summary of yesterday's high points from your speech, just to refresh the memory of the students, after which questions will be asked. Please remember, students, that order is very important as you approach the microphone. So the microphone is right there in the center. So remember order. So ask questions that are relevant to the sector being questioned at the time. Questions will be asked by sector, beginning with the presidential candidates. Each sector is allotted no more than 10 minutes for questioning. And just like yesterday, you're going to look forward. There's Kamal with the time signal. So just look at him for the time. If someone is presently speaking at the microphone, form an orderly line and wait on your turn to approach the microphone. Everybody got that? We're orderly people and we're going to do this the right way. So give a round of applause. They are very nervous, you know. They're very nervous, I can tell. So just remember to keep your questions brief. They're going to come, they're going to share from their manifestos just to refresh your minds. So we're ready for our debates. You guys are not ready? All right, you can go home. You can go home, guys. Guys, go home. They're not ready. You guys are ready for the debates? All right, so we will begin this afternoon, this course, with general high points reviews in the same order as yesterday. All the best to the candidates.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Bradford Lyons, a second year religion and theology major, and I am vying for the position of USM president. If elected during my tenure, I plan to institute financial services here on the campus to make financial access easier to students and safer as well. We will also be including environmental sustainability. We'd like to increase student worker wages as best as possible. We would like to implement a transportation service to aid students who move around in the community and to the town. We would also like to hear your concerns as it relates to safety, to your academic work, and your well-being. Also, we would like to implement a mentorship program that will help the students to become the leaders that they are destined to be here at NCU. And of course, we want to empower you with the skills needed to be successful persons as you leave this great institution. To close, it is only when we try that we can succeed. I hope that you will all vote for me as your president. I look forward to working with you.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Richard Bolton, and I am a third-year student of the School of Religion and Theology. If you were here yesterday, or if you have watched the manifesto that was presented, I'm just going to be brief. So one of the first projects that I had was the Castor Seed Project, and that is one of them that is a main point in gaining financial stability to student. Also, we have the Student Support Group. So this will liaison with the final year student in the Religion and Theology, and also the College of Behavioral and Social Sciences to encourage and to mentor students. We have the development student talents. I will locate future entrepreneurs and make them a part of my team so that the creative mindset that they have can be lay the foundation for great things to help this noble institution here at NCU. And also we have the sales club partnership with them in order to build income for students that have financial challenges. And I have here on my agenda as well the mentorship program to help students that are in need. And finally, the student help box.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Chevelle Wilson, your candidate for VP of Academics for the 2024 to 2025 regime. And as I stand here to summarize my manifesto, I will not present to you any pretty words to appeal to your emotions, rather to just debrief you on my initiatives. One, a student service network that is a two-part program comprised of peer advisement and a revamping of our freshman seminar course. Two, an initiative to help source volunteers for students who need to do dental cleaning, phlebotomy work, or simple surveys, helping to find volunteers. Three, a So You Want to Be initiative that is geared towards educating us on the different opportunities we have available to us as students once we get our degrees. Debate competitions, spelling bees, escape rooms, outreach programs, studying initiatives, and so much more that will help us to look, think, and act as the professionals that we are. And yesterday the question was asked regarding what's the difference between we the new candidates and past regimes who made promises who seemingly failed. The difference is, if it is fine to give up after a few failed attempts, then we would not have many of our great inventions today. So I am proposing different approaches. So vote for Chavel.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kayla Hart, a third-year psychology major with a minor in law. No, as stated yesterday, I'm not here to make promises. What I'm here to do is to tell you what I can do for you. And the first thing that I will be proposing is that we have mandatory sessions that are geared towards our academic advisement process. Secondly, we will collaborate with the records department to aid third and fourth year students in their academic development, where we would set up booths in this gym. And students will have a one-on-one session with the representatives to track their progress so that we can know where we're at and what we need to do before graduation. Thirdly, I will propose that we have an academic wall that is geared towards students with a GPA below 3.0, and we're going to work with these individuals because at NCU, we believe in affirmation, and it's not only about high GPAs, it is also about building character. It is also about helping others improve and to stride. Now, on April 24th, vote hard, vote smart. Thank you.
All right, so yesterday I shared a brief rundown of my intended plan. So now I want you to imagine with me a protagonist. His name is Joe. Joe, an eager-to-learn freshman, begin his university life ready to learn. Joe had in his intention to achieve high GPAs semester after semester. Joe thought of being active in every club. He thought of being active in every event. Yes, a thought, that's all he had. At the end of his semester, Joe ended with a 1.34 GPA, and that's what he left school with. Let's rewind the clock. 4 years back. So Joe started his university life as an enthusiastic individual. He went through his first year being an active member in three clubs, a spiritual, social, and academic club. He decided to participate in the departmental competition, debating competition. He decided to be a peer advisor. He decided to be everything that is in my manifesto. He decided to join the Wellness Wednesday session, and at the end of the program, Joe became a better individual. You are Joe. The decision is in your hand. On April 24, make that right choice and choose Ryan. Amen.
Good afternoon, everyone. So my name is Monet Williams, but most of you may know me as Moana. I go by the philosophy, anything worth doing is worth doing well. So your safety, your social development is important to me. So I plan on bringing the initiatives such as the shuttle bus service to provide transportation for each and every student here at the Northern Caribbean University. Not just main campuses, but regional campuses as well, because they do feel left out. So we have to incorporate them in our plans. Also, I want to incorporate the announcement via the ARIAN system. This will foster the sense of communication between the student body and the students. Thank you. On April 24, remember, with money in mind, leave your limitations behind.
Good afternoon, everyone. Put God first, dream it, work for it, and you will accomplish it. My name is Shanique Knight, and as I stated before yesterday, I am vying for the position of Student Services and Social Affairs. And the reason why I'm vying for this position is because I am no less than you. We are equal students, and because we're equal students, and I know that you would like someone to be the voice for you, and I have what it takes to be the voice for you, That is the reason why I am vying for this position. So under self-improvement and advancement, I will be having a back-to-school drive. That's just to motivate you coming into school on campus fall 2024. I will also be having a grand freshman concert because I know that freshmen normally feel left out. I will also be having Recharge and Topic Tuesdays. I realize there's a lot of inactive club on campus and we need to get the clubs together. I will also be collaborating with the counseling center to ensure that you use up your counseling time here. I will also be awarding the most outstanding club, and most of all, I will be advocating. Remember, we need to fix the menu at CAF. We need to fix the library time and many others. Vote Shanique Knight to make it right.
Good afternoon, NCU. To remind you, this is your Captain Jendai Franz speaking. I'm here to remind you of my plans for the new VP of Student Services and Social Affairs voyage. To begin, my first initiative is TALFest. It's a talent festival where you will be able to come and display all your hidden talents. It allows you to advocate on behalf of the issues that you may be having in a creative way. My second initiative is Straight Out the Law Book. It's an Instagram short series that allows you to be educated on your rights here as students. My third is Beaconite Village Day. It is a day where we turn NCU into a mall using the clubs and the different departments to create little shops. Versus Revamped is a gospel concert where you can pull groups together and create a gospel song and create a gospel song, sorry. Take It Off Your Chest is an initiative that allows students to voice their concerns in online and in-person interviews. NCU, if you are given a choice, it is up to you to decide the type of leader you want. On April 24th, 2024, secure your ticket and vote France to advance.
Online viewers, competent candidates, and valued students, good afternoon. My name is Tony Ann Barrett, and I am vying for the position of Vice President of Student Services and Social Affairs. I will now be listing a few of my plans, as we only have a minute to go through. Wayose, which is an anonymous platform where you voice your concerns, Legal Laydown, or Monthly Games Night, Rhythms of Jamaica, Club Week, Rapid Connections, or Swift Bonds, and of course, Mr. and Miss USM, Spirit Week, Bonfire, and of course, to bring back our freshman prince and princess. Let us make the right decision together. Let your voices be heard through your vote. On April 24, put your X beside the T, and let us shape a future where students strive together.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Abian Mitu, and I am vying for the position of VP of Finance and Planning for the upcoming regime. Just to refresh you on what was presented yesterday, we have the Student Scholarship Fund that I would like to raise from 2.5 million to 2.7 million. I will also be continuing the Student Worker Scholarships to assist student workers with their tuition. Other initiatives include the biannual Student Appreciation Day that will be held to allow students to relax and de-stress courtesy of the USM. Next, we have the USM meal vouchers, which will assist students with purchasing lunches from the school's cafeteria. And the new initiative that I would like to do is a grand themed fun day that will not only be held for students to enjoy, but the funds made will be used to increase the meal voucher allowance and USM scholarships. So remember, on election day, vote Abian, the woman with the plan.
Good afternoon, Beacons. I am Anthea Adderley, your VP of Spiritual Affairs candidate. As said yesterday, politics is not my forte. Howbeit, I'm here. And it is my belief that holistic spirituality is what the students of the NCU need to conquer in this world. So I'm proposing four main foci: spiritual, physical, social, and psychologic. These foci will be brought forth through a regime-long developmental program. This program encompasses all of the initiatives that I will put forth from my sector. As spoken by author Naomi Klein, we live in an interconnected world, in an interconnected time, and we need holistic solutions. Vote Anthea Adderley for holistic spirituality and elevated you in your season of preparation. Vote Anthea Adderley. Together, we will ascend. Thank you.
Right, I love that. No, that was just a recap, of yesterday. For the persons online, you can join in. You can just type your question in the chat, and we will read them to the candidates. Now, students, it is your turn to ask the candidates your questions. Remember, we are doing this in an orderly fashion. So if there are a lot of students there, just form a line, and you can ask the candidates the questions. Okay, the manifestos were sent by CCMPR, so you can check those in your emails as well. So you can look at the manifestos of the candidates. So you can go ahead and ask your questions.
My question is for the VP of Finance and Planning, Ms. Abby Amitu. Can you please come forward? All right, my question is, in your speech, you mentioned some things about scholarships. So my question is, for the USM scholarship, what will be the deciding factor on who will actually receive these scholarships?
Okay, thank you for that question. So to receive the USM scholarship, there will be a criteria. And if you meet the criteria, then you will be a recipient of the scholarship. Some of the criteria would include your GPA and how many credits you have completed. Also, one of the main criteria would be the financial need of the student. So the student would have to write, I wouldn't say an essay, but a brief exposition on how the scholarship would help them out financially. Thank you.
Okay, so I have a question for Bradford Lyons. You can step forward, please. Okay, so I already made mention of making finance more accessible to students, and also you plan to increase the wages for student workers. Can you elaborate on that for us, please? Tell us. How you plan to do that?
All right, thank you for your question, sir. In terms of financial access, what we hope to do is to engage financial institutions, whether it is a commercial bank or a money transfer service, that can open their services here on the campus so that students can access their finances. The second part of your question was in regards to, what again, could you please repeat?
You said you plan to raise...
increase student worker wages. All right, so in terms of increasing student worker wages, I did not promise to do that. What I said was that I can advocate for it. And so we plan to liaison with scholarship and student aid, and from there we will see how best we can get those wages up.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Mr. Bolton, step forward, please. Mr. Bolton, step forward, please. Okay, so you made mention of the support groups. Or will this be different from the STEP representative?
Could you explain what exactly when you mean STEP representative?
Okay, so a STEP representative is a person who works with a freshman to get them integrated into school, you know, teach them the ropes.
All right, just let me say that with the support group, the difference is that there will be two schools that are responsible to assist students with certain needs that they may have. Now, I would have mentioned in my manifesto that these two schools will be based on theology, in theology and behavioral and social science. So they will be mentor for these individuals that needs help. So it may not just be academic, but it can be psychological. It can be anything that they may need assistance with. And these two schools, the theology school and the behavioral school, will provide those assistance.
Good afternoon, everyone. So my question is to the VP of Spiritual Affairs. This one is she alone? She don't have to worry. But what I've realized is that on campus, a lot of the spiritual clubs are dying, and some have already dead. What is your plans moving forward to better?
Thank you for that question, first of all. To revamp the spiritual clubs, not only the spiritual clubs, but every club, even in my club right now, so I understand. To revamp that, I have my team. Those people who I can count on, who I know will do the job, I want them to be pushed to go into these positions so that we won't just have people vying for these positions and getting elected for these positions and not doing anything, because that's really and truly the problem. They're going for these positions and they're not doing anything. Unlike me, of course, that's why you should vote on Thea Adderley for a holistic spirituality. Yes, so the solution is to have my people run for these positions.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I think this thing is kind of high. Good afternoon. I need to ask two questions to the presidential candidates. The first one is to, I will give you the both of you can come. Both of you can come. The first one is, we're having a big problem. We're having a big problem. Across the university at this point, where we don't have Mr. Lyons, Mr. Bolton, anybody vying for positions, neither in USM or in the member organization. As a leader who should take people from where they are, put them where they need to be, what is your plan or plans to fix that problem? Because, you know, you see what is happening now? I remember the days when we never used to have one people running for a position. That is a problem. Now we have so many students, yet nobody is interested. How do you fix that? That's my first question. You go ahead and answer.
All right, you see, when you're structuring your question, you have to be direct and to the point.
What more direct do you want me to be, sir?
Let me say this. Give me a chance to speak. You're making a statement to something, right? All right, in order to help student in their development, rather, in MCU, I have certain plans that are put in place for these students. Now, we have to recognize the plans that are recognized, the problem that the school has. The school has a problem where students are facing financial struggle, and that is a fact. Students also are facing the fact that they don't know who to go to whenever they have a situation. And for my plan or for my manifesto, I have laid out a plan that can help
students. Thank you. Go ahead, yeah. Brad. Let me hear your response.
All right, so thank you for your question.
Yes.
You know, one of the greatest leaders we have seen through Earth's history is Christ. And in order for the Christian to be like Christ, they have to look at him. I promise, and this is the one thing I can promise, is that I will lead with excellence so that there's an example for students to look towards.
All right, Brad, you can't stop. Go and sit. Thank you. Mr. Bolton, Mr. Bolton, my final question to you is this.
Yes.
I hear you present from yesterday in your manifesto that you're going to have some castor bean project.
Yes.
Is who you're going to put on the farm?
All right. You see, that is the thing. And, you know, it's quite appropriate because you are an agriculture
student. I am gone.
Right? And when you ask that question, all right, let me just go straight to the point. Now, the castor seed product is to provide job opportunities for students here on campus. Now, whenever we look at the need, person will volunteer. Why? Because there is a vision behind this. The vision is to let persons have a chance where they can be financially stable. That is one. Where they can have a job to go through, because many have left their job to come to NCU and don't have nothing to do.
All right.
We will provide that financial
help. Thank you. A follow-up question is this, because it's good to have a lot of things to say in presenting this noble idea, because it's indeed an idea that I'm worried about. However, my follow-up question is this. How many persons do you have currently that are willing to work on that farm?
All right.
And if you don't have one, I'm going to advise you to take it out of your manifesto.
No, I would not. I would not. So let me just say that with this project, once it has been initiated to the student body, the USM, if I am elected as president, I will ensure that students come on board voluntarily.
That's not answering the question, sir.
Reason being, listen to it. Reason being is that we will be supported with persons like the ASI that will assist students, will assist this project to be successful. And we have fully partnership with the Jamaica Union. So if it is a case that we want to do the groundwork first, we have persons that will come in and volunteer to take this project on.
All right, thank you. Thank you. I think you know what? It's fine, because I see Madam Parliamentarian coming, so it's fine.
Thank you very much. So, ladies and gentlemen, the other persons can now come, since Lataniel just, you know, gave his whole bucket that was running over. So, other people, you can now come. You're entitled to as many questions, but remember there are other people who want to say something too, okay? You cannot join back the line, no.
Okay. This question relates to the SSA candidates. So, when it comes down to your plans and projections, how do you plan on ensuring that these ethos-friendly initiatives that you have get approved by the administration? Because let's be honest, NCU administration can even resist the simplest ideas. So how do you guys intend on convincing administration to get these plans on? Because campus is practically boring.
Good afternoon again, everyone. So the ethos of NCU should be upheld. I can guarantee you that each plan on my manifesto is indeed ethos friendly. So upon approval, I can guarantee you that there will be less sense of boredom, but more sense of fun and social with social development. Thank you.
Thank you for your question. First of all, the ethos of Northern Caribbean University is one of the most valuable part for me, and that is why I try my best to, you know, portray professionalism. So, first, I will not plan an initiative that goes beyond the ethos. I will make sure that it is ethos friendly. Thank you.
Thank you for that question. So let me begin by highlighting that you said that our initiatives are ethos friendly. They are ethos friendly plans. Therefore, they're already in line with what the university is expecting. But in the case that administration does not say yes, we adjust, take the feedback, adjust, and the plan should go through.
Okay, so I have a question from the chat. It is directed to Bradford Lyons. Can step forward, please. So the question is, you mentioned in your manifesto putting the ATM on campus. Where do you plan to put it?
Thank you for your question. Now, an ATM being on campus, if that is the direction we choose to go, because remember, it is either the ABM of a commercial bank or services for money transfer. Now, if that is the route we choose to go, we have to ensure that the students are safe. And so what we intend to do is to place the ABM at a location where the security is able to always oversee what is happening.
So the question is, where will that location be?
You want to know the exact location?
Yes, that's the question.
Well, as we go forward, we will liaison with the administration to determine where is best suited for an ABM. I do not own NCU's campus. I cannot say that at this point. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, so next question is directed to Ms. Mitu. You can come forward. And the question is, why is it that student workers have more advantage based on GPA to get a scholarship? For a student, it has to be over 3, but for student workers, the GPA has to be 2.5.
Can you please repeat the question?
Okay, so the question is saying, why does a regular student have advantage to get a scholarship over student workers? No, that's what I have here. The question says, for a student, your GPA has to be over 3.0, but for student workers, it has to be 2.5.
Okay, thank you for that question. So what I think is the reason is because the reason why the students are working is because it is showing that they have a financial need. So because of that, I would believe that's the reason why they would put it at 2.5, so that it's not as hard on the student workers to actually get the scholarship.
Okay, thank you. All right, so another question to Ms. Knight. Can come forward, please. So the question is, you proposed a menu change at the cafeteria. How exactly will that be coordinated, and what menu options do you plan to implement?
All right, so. First, I plan to speak with the director. Secondly, I will be running a survey to find out the preferences from the student. After I receive the preferences from the students, then I will definitely be speaking with my upcoming president. After I speak with my upcoming president and we make a plan, we will go through the necessary channel to ensure and try our best to see how best we can get it approved.
All right, don't move. This question is for all the candidates, and it goes like this. As the university transitions into a new era with new leadership, how will you work as the liaison between the students and administration?
Wow, that is why I'm a lady of connection. And to be honest with you, I always put students first. You know, students once said to me, Miss Knight, I didn't know you were a student. I thought you were a lecturer. I said, why? He said, because you're always available. And I am going to make sure, set the connection right for students. And I am an hardworking student, and that is the reason why I was also awarded last month as one of the most outstanding community service students.
The question you asked was how we plan to liaison with the administration.
Yeah. As the university transition into a new era with new leadership, or will you work as the liaison between the students and administration?
All right. Well, there are two sides to that. Firstly, we have to ensure that we know what the students are in need of. Of course, the United Student Movement is here to represent the students. We are the bridge between administration and the student. As such, we need to know what the students need, but we also need to have relationship with this leadership that you speak of, so that we can get plans approved and move forward as we continue to build our great institution called Northern Caribbean University. Thank you.
Thank you for the question. How do we liaison? It's simple. It's a part of our constitutional duty. So if we don't do it, you have the right to speak up and call us out so that we get taken from the position. And as Brad said, we need to know what the students want. We need to know what it is that we're advocating for. So you have to speak to us. Thank you.
All right, thank you for that question. So first, I will listen, and after listening, I will take action, and I will work with the lecturers, the dean, and the vice president of academic administration for the university. Thank you.
Good afternoon once more. Thank you for that question. As stated in my manifesto, I have this anonymous link where students can voice their concerns. As the Vice President of Student Services and Social Affairs, I am required to liaison with the administration. So with the link that is provided, I will know exactly what the students want in order to sit with the administration to make it better.
Thank you for the question. So first you have to listen. One of my initiatives is Take It Off Your Chest, where students are given in-person interviews, links, Instagram messages, etc., so that they can come in and voice their concerns in the first place. And then when I get those concerns, I bring it over to the respective administration, because it is my job as your bridge to bring those issues that you have and, in the best of my ability, solve them.
Thank you for that question. So first and foremost, we have to listen to the voices of the students, and we are all students. We have to connect with each other. Another thing is that once we listen, you guys also voice your concerns and your solutions. And then I will be able to bring that forward, put it on the table to say, this is the challenge that the students are having, and this is what we plan to do. It takes a community. It takes togetherness in order for us to bridge the gap and to get your issues resolved. Thank you.
Okay, good afternoon again, everyone. So to answer that question, an advocate is someone who supports a proposal wholeheartedly. Now, to bridge the gap between VP of Academic Administrative Staff and the students, I must first understand your issue. And I can tell you, I understand the frustration of not getting through to your advisors, of not getting your grades in time. Matter of fact, I'm yet to receive a grade from last term. So I am a person who will be able to stand before each committee valiantly, not afraid to speak what is the right thing to say. Thank you.
Good afternoon again, everyone. So, remember that most time you guys will have issues and you don't know who to go to, right? So the initiative that I have in plan will be a residential roundtable talk for dormitory students, and for the persons that are not living on campus, I'll facilitate Google Forms where persons can reach out to the various medium with their concern, and then I'll take it from there to the necessary administration and advocate on your behalf. Thank you.
All right, so I had shared something in my manifesto, something that will help the student body. Well, one of the important things is to build a relationship with students. I believe that if we don't have a relationship with students, how can we truly connect? I have something in mind, the student help box. Now, the student help box is for persons to go and to share their concern. Because, be honest, sometimes they don't want to talk to any administrator. They don't want to talk to anybody. But sometimes they maybe want to say something anonymously, and they can drop this within the box, and these concerns will be met at each week.
Okay, so thank you for that question. So in order to bridge the gap between us and the administration, we first have to know what are the financial needs of the students. Now, an example that I can give, and it's something that affects me as well, is when it comes on to exam time or when school is supposed to start, the finance office takes a long time to register us for our classes and exams. Examples like this, I would go to speak with the different finance persons so that I can make sure that every student is registered on time for both classes and exams.
All right. My question, well, I have a few questions, but the first is to Ms. Knight. So we have a lot of activities like freshman social at the beginning of the school year, and sometimes it doesn't get much support. However, you proposed a grand freshman concert. How will you get the freshmen who are not yet familiar with anyone on campus or methods of communication to come out to this event?
Great question. So you see, because I'm a STEP representative for the Department of Recruitment and Admission, I know that I can connect to each student through this channel.
Okay. All right. The second question, she has it coming, it's to Miss Adderley. All right, so we're having challenges from the students' perspective. The cafeteria on Sabbath closes at 2 p.m. and church often does not finish in time enough for them to leave here, walk up to the caf, get their food, and get out before it closes. Do you have anything in mind to resolve such a solution, resolve such a problem?
Thank you for that question. So, as you all know, or don't know, church, NCU church, always has potluck. But even so, if you don't want the potluck, you need to speak to us. It goes back to you telling us what your problems are. If I don't know that you're at CAF right now and you're hungry and the CAF is closed, you have to tell me so that I can speak to the relevant people so that the CAF can be opened again for you to eat. Because that is all a part of holistic spirituality, catering to your physical. Thank you.
All right, good afternoon, everyone. So this question is geared towards the presidential candidates. So my question to you is this. What can you do as the president to unite the executive members within this organization? Because over the years, I have observed that the most productive regimes exuded a high sense of inner unity. So this question is for the presidential candidates.
Thank you for that question. Well, based on the Constitution, it is the job of the president to ensure that the executive works together. If there is conflict, it is the president's job to act as mediator. As such, I intend to have events just for the executive where we can become familiar with each other, get to know each other, respect each other, and lead together with excellence.
I believe that in order to truly join persons together, we have to be familiar with each other. I will have places that we as the USM body can go, because sometimes we have to have social event. It is not just every time about the meetings and everything. And in order to build a connection, a close connection, you have to socialize. And I believe in that way you can have a more friendship bond with each other. Thank you.
All right, so I have a follow-up question. Brad, could you come back to the stage? Yes, I have a follow-up question. This isn't my question, but seeing I'm here, I'll ask it. So as religion majors, especially given the role you're vying for, how can you guarantee that I'll be accurately advocated for when being too vocal may jeopardize your future as a potential pastor?
Thank you for that question, sir. Now, please settle down, everyone. Settle down. As a religion major, let me just be sure that I have the question correct here. As a religion major, how do I plan to advocate for students when being too vocal may jeopardize my job as a potential pastor?
Yes, your future as a potential pastor.
My future correct. As a potential right. pastor. Thank you very much. You see, as a potential pastor, it is my job to stand up for what is right. As such, here at NCU, as a student, I am at the training ground where I will have to stand though the heavens may fall. And so, if elected president, I intend to advocate for each and every student as God would have it be.
Bradford answered the question. I'd like the other candidate to answer as well.
Oh, you're not interested. You're never interested.
All right. One voice, please. So as potential pastor in training, we have to deal with different church members from different calibers, different background, different culture, because as a minister, as a representative for Jesus Christ, we stand with a diverse culture of people. And as a pastor in training, I believe that is something that will develop my skill set. It will develop me in order to lead the people of God to victory.
Okay, I have two questions for the SSA candidates. I know that some of you live on Darm, so how are you going to convince the administration or work alongside the administration to improve the facilities on dorm, because some of the machines are not working, some of the dorms of the fridge are not working. How are you going to work alongside them?
Thank you for that question. So I'll reach out to sponsors such as Digicel, Flow, 876, etc., to pool funds to facilitate these equipments on dorm and to ensure that equality is being distributed, because Lila Reed just can't just get the equipments alone. Cedar Reed just cannot get the equipment alone, but JR residents need them as well. All dorm need these equipment. So I will work alongside the admin department, along with everything that I have in me as a candidate for this position, to ensure that the concern of the dormitory students are being met. Thank you.
Thank you for your question. So first, I will try to fix the business internally. If it cannot be fixed internally, I will be going externally. And based on research, I know that most of the dorms are locking equipment. They're locking utilities and so forth. And I promise to, if it even takes for me, especially the cleanliness of the dorm, if it even takes for me myself to join in and clean that dorm, I will. I am not a dorm student, but I am a dedicated person that will do that. In January, I went and I cleaned the Department of Humanities, Behavioral and Social Sciences, and I am dedicated to definitely take full charge of the dorm to ensure that your well-being is okay.
Thank you for that question. So for one, I would begin by speaking with each dean for each dorm to see what are the issues, what are the problems, and what needs to be fixed. And based on those issues and those problems, then we will go to our alumni, our supporters, and see where they can help to fill in the gaps that we are missing.
Thank you for that question. Seeing as I am not a dorm student, firstly, I would have to go to the students on dorm to find out what issues and what equipments are not working. After that, I will go to the administration. We have custodial. If we have people here who are equipped to fix the equipment, we don't need to spend any money to fix them. We can simply go and request, or they can come along with us to try and fix all the issues that we have. Thank you.
Good day, everyone. This question is for Miss Mitu. Miss Mitu. Yesterday, you were asked a question from a panelist that you were not able to answer. Today, I propose the same question. As the VP of Finance and Planning, you will be able to create a budget. What are two things on a budget?
Thank you for that question. So first of all, I would have to answer the question of what is a budget. Now, a budget is an estimate of how much money is made and spent over a period of time. Two things that are included in a budget is, firstly, the income, which is the money that comes in, and expenditure, which is the money that goes out.
Okay, so this question is for Mr. Bolton. All right, so I believe that a leader is someone who is known, who is respected, and who is admired by those who are under them. And I've also observed that most of us were not aware of who you were before this campaign. So do you think that you can lead while we do not know you?
And if so, how do you plan to let us get to know you?
All right. Very good question. Please. No. For me personally, I was on online for the past 2 years. So most persons weren't acquainted or to get to know me. For the next candidate, person know him because he's on campus, he's on dorm. That is a fact. Now, for me as your leader, I have wealth of experience in leadership. I may not mention it in the manifesto, but I have served in many institutions as leaders. And if I become your leader, I believe that with my knowledge that I have hold, I will be able to lead a team of strong executive, a team that will fulfill their obligation, a team that will ensure that the students are being well taken care of.
I think you misunderstood the question.
All right, go ahead. Yes.
As I said before, majority of us do not know you.
All right. So
therefore, the way we
the way
we are receptive to you, the way we respond to you is going to be different because we don't know you. How do you plan to let us know you?
All right. Well, what I'll plan to do is to go out to let persons kind of have that experience with me because I've already started going to places, going to the different departments to let person know who I am. If it means introducing myself, giving a background, I will do it because there is time to do it.
Okay.
Good afternoon. My question is to both persons vying for president. Now, according to the USM Constitution, so the presidential candidates, Mr. Lyons and Mr. Bolton. Now, according to the USM Constitution, there are three main purposes for which the USM exists. What are they?
All right. So the three purposes is one, to serve the student interest. The second one is to advocate for the student. The third is to improve the spiritual development of the student on campus.
Thank you for your question. As my colleague and friend would have said, the purpose of the USM is to advocate for the students, to ensure the students' well-being, and thirdly, it is to ensure that everyone on campus continues to grow as students. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. Question to the candidates running for academics. We all face this problem, our second years and our third years. How do you plan to solve the problem? Of course, it's only being offered once a year, or sometimes not at all. Repeat, how do you plan to solve the problem? Of course, it's not being offered, only being offered once a year, or none at all.
Thank you for that question. So yesterday I stated that accountability must be advocated for. And a part of my duties, and I will quote, is to stand on a committee that I will lead by a majority of the voting council commissioners who will be in charge of education policy, lecture, teacher, instructor, or evaluations. So in essence, it is my duty to be an advocate for you in that situation on each committee that I am on. So you come to me, you say, the course is not being offered. I will advocate for you, and I work with the administration to find the best fit solution.
I'll hold you on to that.
Thank you for that question. So, yes, we are aware that there are challenges as it relates to courses not being offered in a specific semester. And as a result, students are being held back. Now, we have to first think about the needs of the students. And once we think about that, we advocate on their behalf. And in advocating on our behalf, then we can get the administrators to stand with us to make the changes and update the bulletins so that we can have the courses offered in the semesters indicated. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you.
All right, thank you so much for that question. So as a student, I can relate to that. Just last semester, I needed a course and it wasn't offered until summer. So what I would do is to first go to the academic department that course is missing. I would first find out from that department what is happening, because we, as students, though we have problems, we have to find out the problems of that department. Maybe they're short of a lecturer, or maybe it's only one lecturer that is teaching that course. And so after finding out what is happening, we would take the necessary actions from there. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
All right. So my question goes to the candidates running for VP of Student Service and Social Affairs. Now, observing the comments that you guys have been making about getting sponsors. Now, say you get those sponsors to sponsor whatever project you have in mind. Who is going to create those checks and balances to ensure that administration does not misallocate or misuse those funds that you have garnered for your project?
Thank you for that question. Of course, the Vice President of Finance would be in charge of taking care of the funds to ensure that the university does not misplace it. That's why we have a Vice President of Finance.
Okay.
To echo my fellow candidates, that is not necessarily our role, but it will be passed on to the sector that is the VP of Finance.
Thanks for that question. As stated before, the roles and responsibility of the Vice President of Finance will take that up with her role.
Go ahead.
Thank you for that question, Dante. So, to your question, when it comes on to leadership, you don't make decision by yourself. And I will not make a decision by myself to seek external support. I would make sure with my team, I will make the decision and everything will be accounted for. And it leads back down right to the person, the VP of Finance. Thank you.
All right, so my follow-up question is, since everybody passed that responsibility to the VP of Finance, Madam Candidate, could you please provide us with an answer for that question? The question is, say the VPs who promised to find sponsors to fix those things that are so horrible on campus, when you get those funds, how will you ensure that those funds are going into those projects that you guys would have seek sponsor for?
Thank you for that question. Well, when the VPs of Student Services and Social Affairs send me those checks or whatever, the checks will be sent from me to administration. So obviously it would mean that it would be used for a USM event or whatever.
All right. This question, good afternoon everyone. This question is towards VP of Finance, Abian. All right, so this is about club fees. There are students who are unaware of clubs, or they aren't in clubs, but still the club fees are mandatory to be paid. What is the importance of club fees and what do they go towards?
Okay, thank you for that question. So even though a student might not be a part of a club, they are still required to pay club fees. Why? Because these club fees are given to USM so that the different events that you guys want us to hold can be put forward.
All right, so I have a question for Mr. Bolton. And one for Ms. Adeli. So, Mr. Bolton, you mentioned a help box on campus, yes?
Yes.
Okay, so are you aware that we currently have such a box or boxes available at certain locations on campus, for example, the cafeteria and the library? And should you continue to uphold this initiative, who will check the boxes and how frequently? Because those boxes have been sitting there since before I came to NCU.
All right, very good question. Very good. You see, one of the constitution states that the president will give responsibility or give roles, or rather, to unspecified, right, responsibility to individual within the executive body to do that. So whenever there are times that I can try to have a schedule, because sometimes you may have persons doing one and more things, and I will ensure that each person get a chance to check the boxes.
Okay. You are aware that these boxes exist, right?
Yes, I'm aware.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
Ms. Adderley. So my question is, what personal qualities or experiences do you possess that make you well-suited for this leadership role within the United Student Movement?
Thank you for that question. Personal qualities and experiences. As you know, I am currently a president, and I've been a president before. And in such position, you work with people of different values, people of different mindsets, people who bring challenges to what you want to bring forward, what you want for the students. So one of those qualities being understanding, being patient, being able to resolve conflict, being able to empower these people who are in these positions to actually do their jobs as well. Thank you.
You're most welcome.
Me?
Yes, yeah, thank you. All right, good evening, everyone. Yeah, good evening. That's what I said. I have a question for both presidents. Please make your way here. Presidential candidates. All right. And a suggestion afterwards. Over the years, we've been promised that we will be advocated for. Yeah? And we still see a lot of lingering issues that we would have voiced before as students. Could it be that the outgoing regime, could it be that their brand of advocacy looks like one email, yeah, and nothing gets done? What does your brand of advocacy looks like? Because we will hold you accountable. What does your brand of advocacy looks like? Will you nag them so that things can get done? Will you pest them and be in their skin? Will you strike and block the roads? And be mindful of the words now, because this is recorded, right? Yeah.
Thank you for your question. Firstly, one email does not suffice.
That's right.
When we're talking about communication. Of course, many of you have seen me around campus. I don't have a problem to walk, to go to our office and knock on the door and speak with an administrator. But in addition to this, we plan to apply pressure where necessary, if necessary, by letting the school populace know what we are advocating for and what is happening throughout the process.
All right. Could you just repeat the question for me, please?
What does your brand of advocacy look like?
All right. So my brand of advocacy look like this. The promises, I will not make promises, I will make impact. Now, as it relates to information or communication, I will ensure, because in the Constitution it states that the president at times will have every month or every 2 months would have a sit down with the president of the institution. I believe that there could be things would be set in place or to be set in order to have a free flow of information to each student from the entire campus.
Okay, thank you. So one will apply pressure and one will make impact. Okay, we will vote accordingly. All right, I have a suggestion. I have a suggestion to whom it may concern. You see, we need forums like these to have a question and answer session for the outgoing regime, because there are many of us who are concerned as to what they have done. Okay? So please write that down in your diaries. Thank you.
Okay, so question for the president, and this is coming from online. How will you make sure that the other clubs will not feel left out, seeing that the club fees are not being distributed properly? Okay, so let me repeat, and the question is, how will you make sure that other clubs will not feel left out, seeing that the club fees are not being distributed properly? Okay, so the question for the president is, hold on. Oh, will you make sure that the other clubs will not feel left out, seeing that the club fees are not being distributed properly?
I'm not sure there's a question here.
Well, I'm just doing my job.
I understand that, and we appreciate that. You said that question came from online?
Yes.
I'm going to ask the person to rephrase that quickly so that you could ask the question. Thank you.
Unfortunately, we don't have enough time for that. So let's move on. Right. Stay right there. So this question is coming from the Western Regional Campus. And they are asking, just as this current regime did, how do you plan on involving the regional campuses in your plans for the upcoming school year?
All right, thank you for that question. Just today, I spoke with individuals from both the Western Regional Campus as well as the Eastern Regional Campus. And that concern was shared with me, that the students sometimes feel as though they are not a part of NCU. Now, there are two sides to this thing. One is that the regional campuses are a little distance away. And so as a result, we intend to bring them to the NCU campus for major events so that they can feel a part of it. But also we want to encourage them to hold events that mirror what is happening on campus so that they can feel as though they are included and a part of the college, which they really are.
Could you just reframe the question for me, please?
Okay, so the question is, how do you plan to incorporate the regional campuses in your plans for the upcoming year?
Yeah. Just wanted to start off that. All right. So first and foremost, we know that these campuses, as my colleague mentioned, they are far away. So every plan that has been implemented here would have an effect in these other schools. Now, for instance, the plan that I've made, the Castor project, these students will feel involved because they will have the feel to know that, because I want everybody to know this, that every other extension campuses do face financial challenges as well. With something that can put in place for them to earn from, these campuses, they can come on board to ensure that some of these things have been executed. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Final question from online for board presidential candidates. And this one is, if you are not elected to serve, choose one plan from the other candidate that you will undertake. All right, so let me rephrase. For example, you are elected and the other candidate is not. Choose one of his plan that you will choose to undertake.
Thank you for that question. Thank you for that question. Now, I have not had a chance to peruse my opponent's manifesto in detail. However, his idea on helping students through the suggestion boxes. While there are already suggestion boxes here at school, I plan to combine that with what he has suggested so that we can hear the students, so that we can feel the students, so that we can help the students. Remember, lead with lions for unity, prosperity, and legacy. God bless you.
All right, to be honest, there was not much that was shared from my opponent yesterday. Just let me say that one of the things that I've seen, or what he would have suggested about the ATM machine on campus, I think that is a good idea that he mentioned. But also, I would have stated that if it is a case that we have some money to put into those ATM, because with an ATM without no money wouldn't make much sense. So I would just implement that in a long distance vision for the students.
Wow. Wow. That was very intense, wasn't it? It was intense, right? Not agreeing with me? It was. I want to say thanks to all the candidates for their insightful responses and to you, the audience, for being here today and engaging in today's debate. Now, as we approach April 24, the decision of who will lead us into the 2024-25 regime rests in your hands. You've heard their visions, their plans, and their promises. Now it's time for you to reflect on what matters most to you, what aligns with your values, and who you believe has the capability to enact positivity and change for our university. Your vote is not just a choice, but a voice. A voice that shapes the future of our institution. So, on April 24, I urge you to cast your vote thoughtfully, responsibly, and with the confidence that your decision will help pave the way for a brighter tomorrow at the United Student Movement. Thank you To all of you who came today, you've asked your question. So remember, on April 24, you decide. It's your decision. So, may the best candidate win, and thank you all for being here today.
We just want to remind you all of a few things. The candidates, some of them will be available. I know that some questions were not asked. They'll be available to answer your questions a little after the live stream would have ended. Additionally, you're reminded for solo candidates, that's for the VP of Financial Affairs and Spiritual Affairs, there are provisions. If you don't feel confident enough with them, there is a slot that will be provided for no confidence. That's a reminder from EPOC, from the EPOC committee. Additionally, you are also reminded that Sabbath afternoon at 4 p.m. will be Bible Bowl, and Friday afternoon at 4:50 will be the USM Vespers. You're encouraged to come out. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for being here with us this afternoon. You are free to stay back to ask your questions. And the student lounge painting will be done this afternoon. So if you're willing to help at 5 p.m., you can come along with us. Please stand as we will sing our movie on the lawn to at 7. Please stand for the alma mater. Thank you.